Hello, welcome to European Open Briefing for Friday, July the 6th. I'm Rafi Bahajan, currency analyst at XM.com, and we're going to be taking a look at what's happening in the currency markets today. So we do have a bit of a relief rally this morning as the US tariffs coming into effect this morning were greeted with a relative calm. So that relief rally has boosted the Aussie and the Kiwi against the US dollar. We can see the Kiwi up by 0.4% at the moment and the Aussie up by around 0.3%. The Chinese currency, though, the yuan, is slightly weaker this morning. But if you take a look at stocks, we can see most Asian indices are now in the green, having earlier posted some losses. And we're also seeing a positive start in Europe as well. The dollar is mostly weaker this morning, including the Japanese yen, even though the yen itself is down this morning against most major pairs on that slight improvement in risk sentiment. The euro is back above the 1.17 level against the US dollar. We had quite a number of strong data out of the eurozone. We saw strong PMIs early in the week, and yesterday we had strong German industrial orders. And again, from Germany this morning, we had strong industrial production numbers, which have boosted the single currency. On top of that, we're seeing reports that the EU and the US may be seeking a compromise to the dispute over tariffs on cars. The EU has said that it is open to lowering tariffs on US on US imports as long as the US doesn't go ahead with imposing tariffs on European car imports. The pound is steady. Its gains have been somewhat capped by uncertainty as to what the UK cabinet will decide on a customs arrangement with the EU. That meeting will be taking place for much of the day. In commodities, we're seeing oil prices recover slightly from yesterday's losses when they fell on an unexpected increase in US crude stocks. Let's now look at the main movers. We can see there Kiwi dollar, the biggest gainer, followed by oil prices and the Aussie dollar pair. At the bottom, we got the dollar index and gold. Let's have a look now at the Aussie and the Kiwi. We can see the Aussie is back about the 0.74 level, though if you look at its performance over the past 2 weeks, it's still sharply down. The same is true for the Kiwi, although the Kiwi has been making more impressive gains in recent days. It's now back above the 0.68 level against the dollar. So we had that tariff of $34 billion of Chinese imports coming into effect this morning. China has confirmed that it has now responded by imposing tariffs of similar value of $34 billion on US imports. If the US now decides to counter-retaliate to the Chinese response, we could see the start of a trade war. President Trump has threatened tariffs of up to $500 billion US dollars. At the moment, though, there is relative calm in financial markets. We're seeing appetite for risk assets, therefore boosting risk-sensitive currencies such as the Aussie and the Kiwi. Let's now have a look at the dollar-yen pair. We can see dollar has been consolidating since those highs earlier this week. We had the FOMC minutes yesterday. There wasn't much reaction to the minutes, and because it was fairly neutral on balance, because although the Fed was more confident about the economy, there was a bit of a surprise by analysts that the Fed discussed downside risks such as the impact of a trade war, as well as the possibility of a recession due to the yield curve with the narrowing spread of 10-year and 2-year yields, which normally signals this, a recession in the US. So that overall the reaction to that was fairly muted. We do have the US jobs report coming up later today. That's going to be closely watched, especially if there is a strong jump in wage growth. In the meantime, we're still seeing more strong US data. We had the ISM non-manufacturing PMI yesterday sharply beating expectations in June, though dollar yen not reacting too much to that. We're seeing it's currently hovering around 110.50. Turning to the pound, because we're going to have an all-day meeting at the Prime Minister's country retreat of all the UK government senior ministers trying to work out on a customs arrangement with the EU. The current proposal by Theresa May, the Prime Minister, has been criticised by the Brexiteers within her cabinet as well as the EU, which all of whom have said that it's unworkable. In the meantime, though, the UK has been boosted this week from stronger than expected PMIs for manufacturing, construction and services, as well as hawkish remarks by the Bank of England Governor Mark Carney, who yesterday said that rate increases will be needed over the next few years at a limited and gradual pace, signalling an August rate hike. And quick look at today's economic calendar. We've got the jobs report coming up later today, as well as the employment report in Canada as well. That's it for me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.